Okay, this is Shell Chef Tony in part two of my review of the HazLab Ghostbusters Afterlife Spengler's Proton Pack. Now that we've all cleaned up, here we got the Afterlife Proton Pack. And I must say, it looks really, really good. And some people have pointed out that it's not really screen accurate on a lot of places. But I just said close enough. I mean, I'm just happy to have a pack, period. And we got like for example, this yellow whatever it is, wire cover thing. Sorry, I'm not a hardware person. It's not accurate. And some people have remodded them to make them more screen accurate and all, but I'm not gonna do that. Anyway, to begin with, the ion arm, this thing here, goes right here. There are ports right there. You just connect the holes, and it's snug in there. And I don't think you'll have a problem with it getting loose or anything, but just in case you might have to super glue it. But anyway, and here's the stand. I kept saying it's a case. The stand's pretty good, a little hard to assemble, and you're always worried that it might, you know, break. And it's a really good stand, though. Like, and then there's a little Ghostbusters insignia right here. And it's a really good thing you can carry around, like, if you want to, like, something to rest your proton pack on. Like, if you're cosplaying or going to cons or anything, you could put that in your hotel room. But anyway, you know, let's try this baby out. And to get it to work, there's a thing on the back where you can put your batteries in. This thing takes 4D batteries, and I already took the liberty of installing them. And without further ado, let's switch her on. There's a switch right here, the red one, and then listen to her purr. Look at that, those lights. And then also, there's this thing right here. You can turn, increases the sound, or you can even silence it. And some people had complained that of that vibration and humming, sounds like a whale. I don't get it. But there's a solution to that. First, you turn it off. Has a good shut-off sign. Now, if you want to alter the sound and all, you just got to go to the cyclotron right here. Turn this knob here. And slide this baby out. And take this part out to reveal, like, what you saw in Afterlife when Phoebe analyzed the pack. And you got, like, LED lights in there. And, like, these are interchangeable, but I'm not going to touch it. But, like, it's really a good, really fun to do. Fun to look at. Like, you could pretend you're taking it apart into the darkness. And now, right here, there are two switches here. One's to turn on and off the vibration, which I believe is the left. Let me check the instructions. Yeah, it's the left that turns off the vibration, turns off the motor. Then you just hit this, you get a little part. And I'm gonna put this back on and put this back together. Screw it back in. Run it without worrying about the vibration. is okay too. Here's one of my other favorites. Let's open her back up again. Open this up again. Oh, before I forget, there's a little special feature. Rainbow cable right here connects to the cyclotron. You can take it out. I think. It's not down there. Well, anyway. I'm not gonna bother with it. It's just that you can have a little shut off mode kind of thing. But back to unscrewing this. If you don't want it to sound like an afterlife, and you want it to sound more like the 84 carton movie. Oh, and also, this thing is removable. You just gotta take this part out, and then you can take a look at how about this part of the proton pack. It's a hollow plastic, but yeah, look at all that display right there. Really good. Anyway, switch this knob here. Does it again. And put you back in. Back on. And then switch me on. Sounding like she was freshly made in 1984. And here you see like the lights are slow and like better than the afterlife. Is it good? And then if you want to do like a full-fledged proton pack, because it's a pack if you don't have anything to shoot with. So when you got the neutrona one, and that's what this hose is for. Okay, here's how you can connect them together. First, the neutrona one, you gotta open the back, take out the batteries, which it runs on the one, and then I believe this part will go here. Put that down real quick. And then this goes in here. Line it up correctly like you do with the when you put in batteries. And then put that in. And then it'll turn on the pack. turn it off. It turns off too. And then when you turn it on, we're back in action. So you can use your Neutrona one to turn on the proton pack. And then you can just connect it here. It's a little snug. I think it looks like it'll be fine without any stress. So like if you're trucking around in a convention place and put it on. So then, now, all I guess all that's left is to put on the pack. Now I'm gonna adjust the camera a bit because I gotta adjust the straps so you can get a good look at how it looks on my back. Forgot to take some paper off the straps and then adjust it. Give it a little adjusting. Overall, I'm really proud of the proton pack. Bear with me, folks. I'm going as fast as I can. You know what? Let me play with it a little and I'll show you. Let me play with it a little and I'll get back to you. Wait for part 3.